quand on a que l'amour pour unique raison, pour unique chanson et unique secours. Quand on a que l'amour pour habiller matin pauvres et malandrins de manteaux de velours, quand on n'a que l'amour à offrir en prière pour les maux de la terre en simple troubadour, quand on n'a que l'amour à offrir à ceux-là dont l'unique combat et de chercher le jour, quand on n'a que l'amour pour tracer un chemin et forcer le destin à chaque carrefour, quand on n'a que l'amour pour parler au canon et rien qu'une chanson.
That's the day I learned my dog Bubsy was gone. I was crushed. He was everything to me. We spent almost all of our time together. He was my sunshine. My only sunshine. He was the best damn dog in the business. The toughest part? I knew he couldn't just be lost. The dog's a genius. How could he be lost? He knows that he can't do anything outside the house. What does he think he'd do? Buy a pizza? He knows he can't do anything. I knew that someone must have kidnapped him. Someone was trying to spite me in the worst way they possibly could. Someone who knew how much Bubsy meant to me. I had to go and find him, and I knew I'd need all the help I can get. So I decided first to enlist the help of my good friend David. Me and David go way back. We met at a Dave & Buster's for my cousin's birthday party. He was turning 11, but that's not important. I met David through my cousin, but I don't like my cousin. Irregardless, I had to talk to David. David knew Bubsy inside and out. He walked Bubsy every day. He assisted Bubsy's birth. He knew everything there was to know about Bubsy. So I thought that he was my best option.
Sorry, just give me a sec. Jaccobi. Come on in.
So what can I do for you on a beautiful day like this?
Dave, it's hard for me to say this, but Bubsy's gone. I found out this morning.
What? No, it cannot be! Not Bubsy!
But here's the wicked twister. You and I both knew he couldn't just be lost.
Of course not. Dog's a genius. What does he think he's gonna do? Buy a pizza? He knows that there's nothing outside of the house for him to do.
Exactly. The obvious next thought is that he's been kidnapped.
No.
I think so. Dave, you and me go way back.
Oh, yeah. The Dave and Busters.
Exactly. And you helped him Bubsy's birth. You walk him. You babysit him. You know him inside and out. You know his favorite deodorant. Hell, you even know that we love to watch Price is Right together. Therefore, I believe that you'd know more than anybody where he could be.
I wish I could help you, Jaccobi. I really do. I really wish I could help you, Jaccobi. I do. I wish I could help you, Jaccobi. But I really would.
Okay. I understand.
Wait, but I do want to help.
Okay. So do you have any thoughts on who could have done this to me?
Well, I'd assume it would have to be someone that you've wronged. Can you think of anyone, under any circumstance, that you would have done something to? Anyone that would really want to hurt you?
No.
David was clearly a dead end. I was disappointed. Running a case with a good pal was on my bucket list. But he didn't seem to know it.
Jaccobi! Got to be someone that you've lied to, or hurt, or wronged in some way. I even have some guesses. I'll help you find Bubsy.
Jaccobi, you're a smart guy, but you're not perfect. There has to be someone that you've lied to, or hurt in some sort of way, in the many years that you have... What do you do exactly?
Not important. But I get what you're trying to tell me. It's just so hard for me to look Bubsy in the eye knowing that I've done something like that. So I just eradicate all guilt from my noggin.
That sounds incredibly unhealthy.
No more unhealthy than your addiction to drinking Windex.
Whatever. What I'm saying is you need to unrepress these feelings. You need to do it for Bubsy. If you can uncover these thoughts, we can find suspects and get him back. But the more stubborn you are about this, the harder it will be, and the more likely we'll lose Bubsy.
This is tough on me, Ego. Almost impossible. Bubsy means so much to me, but so does my I've never lied to anyone, I'm great t-shirt.
Jaccobi, this is your dog Bubsy we're talking about. He's gotta be more important than that.
Give me till tomorrow, and I'll have a decision. But I also gotta change first. I look ridiculous.
Listen, before you leave, I have something for you. Take this, just in case anyone hurts you. And just remember, the longer you take, the further Bubsy will get.
It was good. I wish I could, but something's hit me like a lead soccer ball straight to the nads.
That's tough. I think I can relate though. This morning I tripped on a wire and my TV stopped working. So I had to put an old VHS tape with some random show on it. I have no idea what it is.
Real funny, Barney. Can you just get me a menu?
Here you are, sir.
Barney, what's this?
Why, it's exactly what you think it is. A truth serum.
What's in it?
Bottoms up.
All right.
You know, you're supposed to order that. David gave me the recipe last week. You know, the French bread is favorite.
Oh, my God. I've lied to so many people. And those people would want to take Bubsy because I've lied to them. And because I've lied to them, they'd want to take Bubsy. And because...
How is Bubsy, by the way?
I gotta go.
My house, I've got no shackles. You can come and look if you want to. Through the halls, you'll see the mantles where the light shines dim all around you. And the streets are paved with gold. And if someone asks you, you can call my name. You're a
or just a thought that someone somewhere somehow feels you should be here. And it's so for real to touch, to smell, to feel, to know where you are here. And the streets are paved with gold, and if someone asks you, you can call my name.
I've lied to so many people. I've done wrong by all of them. And that means I've done wrong by Bubsy. He's like a son to me. And I lied to people and got him taken away. I can't even look at myself in the mirror. What have I become?
It's okay, Jaccobi. It's gonna be okay.
It is not okay. I'm a monster. I got him taken away. He was my favorite, and I was his. I got him taken away.
Well, I think you're overreacting. I know he's your pet, but it's not a big deal. You'll get him back. You'll figure it out.
Huh. Did you say not a big deal?
Yeah, he's your dog. I mean, you'll get him back. Or just get a new one. But I pray that it's the former.
Dave! Jesus Christ, he's my dog! He's my best boy! He's the greatest of all time! He's my one and only best friend, the thrill in Manila. I have to get him back. It's the only way.
Okay, so let's think this through. What did you gain from remembering who you lied to?
Well, it could be anybody. But it's definitely one of three people, but also it could be anybody.
A little indecisive.
What? Indecisive? I'm a detective. I don't even know the meaning of that word.
Jaccobi, always so confident. So I think you got...
What does it mean? That word. What does it mean?
What word?
Indecisive. I said I don't even know the meaning of that word. What does it mean?
Okay. It means unclear. It means like... It doesn't settle the issues.
How dare you? I'm a detective. My findings are never indecisive. I don't even know the meaning of that word.
Jesus Christ. Do you need me to explain it again?
No, I think I got it.
Okay. Well, despite the fact that you may or may not be indecisive, I think with your findings...
Wait. Can you explain it to me one more time?
It's when your findings do not really help...
Never mind. Say it again. Say what you said again. Let me try it again.
Say what again?
About how my findings were indecisive.
Okay. Well, that's a little indecisive.
Indecisive? I'm a detective. My findings are never unclear and always benefit the situation. I don't even know the meaning of that word, figuratively, because it is, in fact, in my vocabulary.
Are you good?
Yes.
Well, I think you know what to do. You just have to get out, get out there and interrogate those folks until there's no doubt in your mind who took Bubsy.
Did you say get out?
No.
David, get my lawyer on the phone. I need to set up a meeting. Ah.
My first instinct when it came to people I'd lied to was to talk to my lawyer. Being a detective, I've gotten into a lot of sticky situations. Me and my lawyer, Ronnie Fitzpatrick, had lied our way out of all of them. He was quite the sleaze. And, if anyone had reason to be mad at me, it was him. I'd been guilty in every one of those cases. I'd only ever paid him $5 for any one job. He was a prime suspect, and I was ready to take him down if I had to.
Jaccobi?
Ronnie? Won't you come in?
I don't know. Should I?
Yes.
Then I will.
Oh.
May I take your hat?
No.
Okay.
Second thought, can't take my hat.
Have a seat. Get you a drink?
No.
I got you a drink. In case you want it.
I don't want it. I believe this is the first time I've been inside your house, Jaccobi. It's an okay home.
Well, thank you. I think it is. I don't like to have many people over. I like to keep a low profile. Keep to myself.
I guess you could say that.
I'd like to think so. I think I...
Or you could say that every other time we've met, I've been getting your sorry ass out of trouble. Whether it be prisons, public parks, sidewalks, you know.
Yes, yes. You've been there for me many times.
Every time, Jaccobi. Every time. You call me, I'm like a goddamn personal police officer, security guard.
Well, yeah, I mean, I can't call police officers. They lock me up. You know that.
Yeah, I know that. I also know the most you ever paid me is $10, and that's because I did 2 jobs for you in one day.
You seem bitter, Ronnie. Something wrong?
You're wrong, you imbecile. I've been wasting all my time and training on you, and all I've been getting is throwaway cash to repay me.
Okay. I understand. But this job is for real.
You say that every time, Jaccobi. Every time it's for real. But not a single one has ever been for real.
Ronnie, you gotta calm down.
No. Jaccobi, taking a real job at a real firm. One that pays well. One that gives me real jobs, where the defendant isn't always guilty. I can start fighting the good fight. No more tricks, no more swindles.
What about bamboozles?
No more bamboozles.
What about curveballs?
No more curveballs.
What about sharp left turns?
No more sharp left turns, no more nothing. You understand, Jaccobi? I'm done. I'm cleaning up, Jaccobi. I start paying my dues, paying back the universe.
If you wanted to clean up, you could have just taken a nice long shower.
It's not what I meant. You knew what I meant.
I don't know if I do. Do you mean rolling around in the mud to get clean? Like a pig?
No. That's what I used to do. Figuratively.
Literally?
I thought we agreed never to speak of that again.
So what's the catch? You're the biggest sleaze in town. You can't just clean up.
Well, I am. It's set. Gotta stop.
Sounds to me like you're quitting.
No, I'm not a quitter, alright? I'm just switching sides.
No, you're quitting.
No, I'm not.
But you are?
No. Got a new job, Jaccobi. I'm done. You're gonna have to find yourself a new sleaze of a lawyer. I'm not gonna do it anymore.
Well, if that's what you really want, I can't stop you.
Thank you, Jaccobi.
But how's about I treat you to a nice goodbye dinner? Something nice, like when we were kids. A nice old dinner. What do you say?
That'd be very nice, Jaccobi. Be pretty pleasant.
Pleasant? What are you? A Tyrannosaurus?
You mean a thesaurus?
Nope.
Nah, Jaccobi. Always so inflexible.
Inflexible? I'm a detective. I don't even know the meaning of that word. You're really cleaning up, eh?
Yes, sir. Got myself a big old office building and everything. Got me a real salary and everything.
Sounds like it's a real gem you've uncovered there, buddy.
Seems like it, doesn't it?
Yeah. Almost seems too good to be true.
Some things could seem that way, yeah.
You're not a real lawyer at a firm, Ronnie, are you?
No. How'd you know?
I'm a detective, Ronnie. It's what I do. Also, you're a major ex-con and a lawyer for cons. Who's famous for his tricks. They don't just hand a guy like that a job at a big fancy firm.
You got me. But I did get a job at a firm.
Really?
Yeah, really.
How so?
put in my resume, get me a position.
Where?
The mailroom, okay? I work in the mailroom.
That's more like it.
I'm the head of the mailroom, though.
Whatever gets you out of bed in the morning, the amigo.
This doesn't look like dinner, Jaccobi. Where are you taking me?
Oh, it's just this cute new little joint called Where's My Damn Dog?
Whoa, what are you talking about?
My dog. My dog, Bubsy. Where is he?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Goodbye. You know exactly what I'm talking about, Ronnie. You've been helping me with cases for the past 10 years. Every single one of them I've been guilty. Only ever paid you in fresh Lincolns, $5 for a job, and you and I both know that that's not nearly enough for a lawyer. But your anger sit and boil for all these years, and then you decide to hit me where it hurts. You decide to steal my dog and sell him for the money it would take to pay you back for all the jobs. I'd give you a pat on the back if I weren't so pissed at you for taking my damn dog.
I'm sorry, Bubsy's taken. I swear, I did not do it.
Come on, Ronnie. If you didn't do it, you gotta prove it to me now. Spill it, for I spill you.
I'll admit it, I was pissed every time you underpaid me, but once I got the job at the firm...
Mailroom job.
At the firm. I felt like I was set free, like I've been given a clean slate. Not gonna lie, what I planned to do was take the job and stop serving you. All my other clients. Just forget any of you ever happened. Never speak to any of you again. Just take the job, work my way up, and leave you all to wonder where I went. But then I got your call, and I thought it'd be fine if I came to say one last goodbye before I left you forever. That's as nasty as I was gonna get with you. I'd never take your dog, I promise that. And you can trust me now. I'm cleaned up, for real.
Normally I wouldn't trust you, Ronnie, but you said for real. So you must be serious.
I am, I swear.
Can't believe I'm saying this, but that checks out. All right, Ronnie. You can get out now.
But I don't have a ride. My car's at your place.
It's been towed. I technically don't live at my house. You know your way around. Get out.
But...
Get out! Come on, get out! At the mailroom, Ronnie.
Mailroom at a firm!
I was sure Ronnie had done it. So when I found out that he hadn't, I felt drained. So I wanted to stop by the bar for a quick cup of coffee. But then, all of a sudden...
You might want to stop finding out something.
That's so vague, man. Just tell me who you're working for.
Why would I do that? Just back off. Stay back. Third sentence. Boss's orders.
Even though I knew that now I was being followed, I didn't stop my search for Bubsy. I wanted to know where he was no matter the cost, be it physical punishment or talking to someone I really didn't want to talk to. So I decided to enlist the opinions of my ex-wife. I didn't have a very good standing relationship with her. She'd marry me for the money, and when she realized I didn't even have a bank account, she left me faster than I could recite all the lyrics to Sweet Child of Mine. But since she hated me and everything I stood for, it made sense to me that she'd take Bubsy, or at least keep track of his whereabouts after he'd been taken. It was gonna take all the confidence and patience that I had, but if it could help me locate Bubsy, I was happy to do it.
Are you gonna say anything? All right. Well.
Wait, hold on. What's up?
Seriously.
Damn it, Lola, wait.
What?
Can I please come in?
Yeah, I guess so.
Damn it! Don't like what you've done with the place.
Yeah, well, I have money now, so I can do what I want with it.
Well, I would have money right now if you didn't tell me to follow my dreams and become a detective.
How is it a bad thing that I told you to follow your dreams?
Because now I don't have money.
I said join the police force and work your way to becoming a detective.
Did you never know me at all, Lola? I do not work. I am an opportunist. Things come to me, and I take them. For that is the detective lifestyle.
No. It's not. Detective is a real job. It has real research involved and real responsibility to it. You actually have to train for it.
Oh, Lola. Dear sweet Lola. To paraphrase my lawyer, so inflexible.
Do you mean inflexible?
No. That wasn't it. Lola, don't you understand? Detective is about lying on your ass for 95% of the year. Then someone comes to you with a case that's personal. Then you go rogue and solve it while shooting guns, writing in a notepad, and smoking as many cigarettes as possible.
But you don't smoke.
No, I don't.
So you're not a detective.
Lola, don't be silly. Of course I'm a detective.
What do you have written in your notepad?
That's none of your business.
Jaccobi, I know you. There are not now, nor will there ever be, any patterns in the lyrics of Don't Stop Believing.
Man can only prepare for his dream case.
Jaccobi, I feel like we've had this conversation a million times. You are not a detective. When you have a real case, then maybe I'll sit up and pay attention. But until then, unless you have something important to say, please leave.
But this time I have a real case, I swears it I do.
You've said that a million times, Jaccobi, I don't believe you.
But what if I told you I had a superpower that allowed me to stretch my legs so long that I could touch the clouds?
Then I wouldn't believe you either.
Damn. That'd be a pretty cool rumor. But anyway, I do have an important case I need to solve.
Oh, really? What is it?
Someone very important to us both has been taken. Do I have your attention now?
Yes. Yes, you do. Would you like to take a seat? You're sweating a lot, and I'm afraid you're going to bleed out. Your nose is so bad. Please, take a seat.
If you insist.
So what happened? Who's gone missing? Who is it? When did it happen? What's it all about?
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Slow down. Give me a second to compose myself.
You still haven't told me who it is!
Calm down. Calm down. I'll tell you who, but you're not gonna like hearing this.
Who is it?
It's Bubsy. He's been taken.
You're right. I don't like hearing about that.
Now, why don't you like hearing about that?
It's because all you ever did was talk about the damn dog. All you did was spend time with the dog. And the only time you spent my hard-earned money was on that dog. And you did that a lot.
What? What are you saying?
All you ever did was pay attention to that damn dog. That's why I left. I could have cared less about the money. And you could have cared less about me.
That's exactly what I wanted to hear.
Excuse me?
That's all the evidence that I need.
What evidence?
Evidence that I needed to put the case away, because now I know that you stole Bubsy.
What the hell are you talking about?
Come on. It couldn't be more obvious if it knocked on your door. I'll admit, I spent a little more time with Bubsy than I spent with you. But to be fair, I knew Bubsy before we even met.
We picked out Bubsy together.
Well, I could tell once we got him that we were spirit brothers.
What?
We've been brothers in a past life. It's complicated. Anyway, I spent what you thought to be too much time with Bubsy, and you got so angry that you left him and I with no money, no home, just the clothes on our back. But as time went on, you saw that instead of suffering, we blossomed into beautiful flowers. And it killed you that we were so happy together. So you decided to do the one thing that could kill our vibes. Tear us apart. So you took him and pawned him off to get back the money I spent on him. Or knowing you and how evil you are, you're probably working him like a mule right as we're speaking now. I figured you out. All you gotta do is tell me where he is, I'll take him, and I can be on my way.
That's some very paranoid thinking, Jaccobi. Almost impressively so. But, like usual, that is dead wrong. Did I hate that you were spending more time with a dog than me, your own wife? Yes. Did I leave because that occurrence is completely ridiculous? Yes. Would I ever bother to steal that dog? Of course not. I'm a normal person that has a job and real things to do. I don't have time to steal a dog. Nor do I know where you live because I don't even know if you have a house. So would I be better if you were upset about what you did? Maybe. But would I put in all that time and effort to steal your dog? Absolutely not. That's stupid. That's not even the problem. The biggest problem is that you didn't just do this to me. You ignored a lot of people because of the dog. I'm sure there are people you've insulted and ignored looking for him right as we speak.
I don't know if I believe you. I think you took him.
I technically own all of your suits. If I wanted the money you owe me, I'd just sell those. Not the damn dog.
Well,
I got you, Jaccobi. I didn't steal him. You can go now.
You're listening to the song about your name. It's a little vain, isn't it?
Nope. It's a good song. I'd like it anyway. Are you gonna try again? Are you gonna try to burn me again?
Yeah. You look tolerable.
And you look like a Grammy nominee in photo negative.
So how'd the investigation go? No. Huh.
How could this happen, David? How?
I'm gonna guess it hasn't been going so well.
Hasn't been going well doesn't even begin to describe it. I narrowed it down to a list of 3 people, and I interviewed both of them. I had them on the ropes, I had them right where I wanted, and they bested me. Neither of them did it. Neither of them even knew where Bubsy was.
Well, not going so well does begin to describe it, if not fully. Okay. You said you narrowed it down to 3 people, but you only interviewed 2 of them. There's still one more you could try.
Yeah, I guess so.
Well, who is it?
Laurel. Laurel the Loan Shark. He was the 3rd overall prospect in the whole stole my damn dog draft. Brought to you by Sprite.
Laurel the Loan Shark? That guy's a scumbag. He's disgusting. He's gritty. He's an awful human being. You can't interview him.
Despite the fact that he is all those things, I do want to interview him. I owe him a lot of money and loans. He'd take Bubsy. I gotta talk to him.
No, no, no. You don't want to do that, Jaccobi. Why don't you just let me talk to him?
David, I appreciate you want to help me out. You're a good friend for that, but I need to talk to Laura myself.
Just let me talk to him.
David. David. I'm glad you're so eager to help me out, but you're not a detective. I am. You don't have the cunning mindset needed to interrogate somebody. I appreciate the offer, but I'm gonna have to take this one.
This was the last suspect, Laurel the Loan Shark. I'd been avoiding this interview, hoping to God that it was one of the others because, to be honest, I was scared out of my pants about this one. Laurel was a dangerous man. Ever since we were kids, him, Dave, and I, he'd wanted to be a loan shark. He'd make small deals on the playground, and whoever didn't pay him back wouldn't get picked for kickball. As we got older, he became more and more serious of a loan shark. I began taking more important loans from him because I thought I could trust him since I'd known him since we were kids. But then he started getting dangerous, and I broke it off with him, but not even paid him back. I hadn't seen him in years, and Lord knows that even a day is too long not to pay back a loan shark. Needless to say, he had reason to steal Bubsy, but I'd be a liar if I said I wasn't scared to find out if he did.
Well, if it isn't Jaccobi, what's your last name again?
I could ask you the same question.
I asked first.
Well, I'm not gonna tell you.
Why not?
Because I don't wanna.
I triple dog day to tell me your last name.
Speaking of dogs, let me come inside. This place is disgusting.
Really, I think it's quite nice.
You're right, it's really nice.
Yeah. Why don't you have a seat right there?
Fine. Hotel California, huh? Good song.
Great song.
Sure. Great.
So it's been a while, Jaccobi, hasn't it?
Yes. Yes, it has.
Now, why is that? Why do you think that is?
Maybe it's because I've been busy. Maybe it's because you've been crazy. Maybe it's because you killed a guy after he didn't pay you back for going splitsies on a washer dryer.
Hey! That was business! It's all business. Nothing personal. Just business.
So no case you've ever done has ever been personal? Not even if someone, say, was a best childhood friend and, like, hasn't called you in a year?
I don't believe so, no.
This interview should be very easy for you.
Interview? What? What, am I in trouble or something? Eh?
Maybe you are. Maybe you're not. You could be, but there's a chance that you're not. But there's a percentage chance that you are. But you definitely are.
Whoa! Let's not go making wild accusations here.
You're nasty. You're a thief. You're a murderer, Laurel. I know you are. If the other two aren't guilty, that means you are. I know it. And I'm running on no sleep here, so let's make this nice and easy.
What in the world are you talking about?
My dog, Laurel. My dog, Bubsy. I came home yesterday morning after a long night, and he was gone. I looked all around my house. He wasn't there. He's never left my property. He knows that he came. He has to have been kidnapped. I made a list of all the people I'd ever wronged. Narrowed it down to 3 people. The other two are innocent, so it had to have been you. So just give up and make it easy.
Oh, Jaccobi. You put in so much effort to solve a case where the answer's right in front of you.
What are you saying?
I'm not saying anything.
Well, you just did. And it sounded like you were trying to give me a hint.
Maybe I was. Maybe I wasn't. I don't know.
What's with all this wishy-washy business?
I don't know. Maybe it's because we were best buds in school and you haven't called in a year. Maybe it's not.
You're making it sound like that's the problem. But you said you never let things get personal.
Maybe I did let it get personal. Maybe I didn't.
Stop being so vague, man. Did you do it or not?
No. No, I didn't.
Okay. So are we Hotel California?
We're Hotel California, all right.
Welcome to the Hotel California. It's a lovely place. It's a lovely face. Living it up in the Hotel California. It's a lovely place. It's a lovely face.
Who did it? Who did it? Who?
I didn't do it. But I helped. Came to me and we agreed. And you've been ignoring us too much for the dog. Told me we should steal it. I give it back. I didn't do it, but I helped. It was his idea.
Who is he? Who is he?
David.
No! It can't be! Not David! Wait. He knows I'm here. That must mean he's gonna...
Nice of you to join us.
No, David, no! You gotta calm down. Why would you do this?
Oh, you know why.
I know I might have ignored you, but if you keep Bubsy safe, I'll budget my time more, I promise. I realize today how irresponsible I've been all these years. It's time to change.
Oh, well, it's too late now. That might have been the problem at the beginning, but trust me, things have changed. Okay? At the start, I was really mad at you, okay? I was real mad at you. But listen, when I took that dog so you could spend more time with me, I realized what an amazing dog he was. You know, now I don't even want to hang out with you anymore. I want to hang out with Bubsy. I want to be Bubsy's best boy.
David, have you gone mad? Throughout this whole time, it seemed like I could have been a massively flawed anti-hero, maybe even the villain. But now, because of your massive 180, you're the clear antagonist.
Yep, you got me. Okay, you solved the puzzle, but now it's time for you to go.
Now that I gotcha, I'm gonna talk about some things that don't really matter. So there's this young boy who's been
there. What is it? What is it, boy?
Excited. Hey, oh my.
What the hell is going on here?
Muscle Man Ex Machina.
So cold.
And as I stood there with my best boy, Bubsy, after all the stress and physical beatings I'd taken, I thought about something mostly unrelated, but meaningful.
that I'd spent these whole entire last 2 days without sleeping just to get back my dog. And it was then that I realized how meaningful pets are. We adopt these animals into our lives, not realizing that they're about to become big-time family members. They form bonds with us as strong as anything, and we often leave those bonds unrecognized, or if they are recognized, underrated. A relationship with a pet can be one of the most meaningful you can find outside of your blood family, and that's really something. In elementary school, when they teach you fire safety, they tell you not to save the pet, because you can replace them. Well, I'd say, you better save the damn pet, because at least to me, that cat, that bird, that dog is irreplaceable.